on the line, Philippine Central Bank Governor Ben Diokno. Gov, I didn't catch it earlier. It was a scratchy line. So what was it like in self-quarantine?
Well, nothing. I just read a lot, and I continue to work while in self-isolation. So nothing different.
Okay. So how much of a bump will your latest policy rate easing bring? The rate cut that happened on Thursday, is that going to be enough to compensate for the economic growth slowdown from COVID? I mean, Reuters poll last Friday revealed that the world is already in recession.
Yeah, that's right. We have to keep in mind that this is a once-in-a-lifetime crisis. So, as you said, the global economy is going to slow down. I think the new forecast is 2% globally from 3%. Many developed countries are going to go into recession. And the ASEAN region, which is one of the fastest-growing regions, will probably end up growing at 3%. And the Philippines itself, I think, based on the BSP staff estimate, will slow down to 5% from 6.5 to 7.5%. So this is global. But I think depending on how effective the enhanced surveillance, we'll probably come out of this maybe on the fourth quarter of this year. In fact, from 5% to 5.5, the BSP estimate that will bounce back to 6.8% next year.
You've decided to cut by 50, so that's brought down the overnight repurchase rate, overnight lending and deposit facilities to 3.25, 3.75, and 2.75% respectively. How much more in basis points can the central bank cut the key policy rate as well as reserve requirement ratios?
So right now, the policy rate is 3.25. So, and with easing inflation also, I think we have a lot of policy space. So, so we look at the situation. I think right now we feel that the 50 basis points cut is enough. It's consistent with the new growth target. And if there's a need for more policy action on the part of the central bank, we'll do so. But right now, I think a strong, massive fiscal stimulus is needed to complement what we have done. In addition, Kathy, we adopted a lot of administrative measures, temporary regulatory relief from BSP, and that could also help the increase liquidity in the system. For example, we increased the single borrower's limit from 25% to 30% for a period of 6 months, extendable depending on the seriousness of the pandemic.
I'll pick up on that and that phrase you mentioned, strong, massive fiscal stimulus, in a moment. But I wanted to know first, what other tools is the central bank looking into to mitigate the impact of COVID? I was speaking earlier with Natixis chief economist for Asia Pacific, Alicia Garcia Herrero, and she recommended a couple for the BSP to introduce some kind of quantitative easing type facility to buy assets and perhaps engage the IMF for a potential line of credit based on U.S. dollar liquidity needs.
Yeah, we can access that, but at the moment we will exhaust all domestic policies that we can deploy. I know that IMF, ADB, and even BIS, the international banking settlement system, is willing to lend some money or give us some additional tools. At the moment, I think we're comfortable with what we have right now.
On the fiscal side, what is your view about adopting a fiscal stimulus program that will raise the country's deficit to GDP ratio to close to 5%? It's one of the recommendations brought on by more than 30 business groups.
Yeah, I think it has to be consumer-based. I think we have to address the fact that many people are not employed right now or do not have sources of income because of the isolation. We need to address them. Maybe give them some cash grant for the next maybe 2-3 months. okay, those who lost their job or those daily wages who can't work, I think they have to be, their needs have to be addressed. And then probably the fiscal stimulus has to be well targeted. I think since we are working with a Luzon-wide embargo, we have to take for example, initially the top priority will be Metro Manila. In fact, I would argue a greater Metro Manila to include Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal, plus the Metro Manila area. Look for people who are in need at the moment. I think the president's declaration of nationwide calamity is good because then that releases money that are in the budget of the local government, the calamity fund, so they can initially disburse the funds as Congress, which is going to convene tomorrow, I think, who's working on this fiscal stimulus. So LGUs will initially provide the wherewithal of the people who are affected by this isolation, and then I think in 2 weeks, or no, 2 weeks' time, the money coming from the national government will kick in. So that should be the nature of the calamity. No infra. I think this really needs the income supplement for the poor and those affected by this isolation.
We're on the fifth day of the Luzon-wide lockdown, Governor, and the main concerns have revolved around access to money. What steps has the central bank taken to keep banks open and cash in automated teller machines? Because we've been receiving feedback from different customers. They most often end up finding an ATM without money or a bank branch that is shut.
There is an unusual demand for cash, more than the usual. For example, the usual practice is that you buy from the grocery, they will of course reuse the money. But I think there is a desire on the part of the banks to use new money, so it is easier to put in the ATM. So there's a need for new cash, and we are complying with that. Printing complex in Quezon City is open, and we will continue to provide for the needs of people. Okay. And also, we have alerted the regional distribution centers to make themselves available should the need arise.
So are you ramping up operations at the printing machine and the distribution? And if so, how many times in a day in filling those ATMs and making sure they've got money?
We have reduced work hours, so from 9 to 3. They can go to our Quezon City plant. And, of course, we also have our Metro Manila plant and other regional distribution centers. So don't worry, the cash is available, and I said people will panic if we say we're rationing cash. So what we do is we'll give cash as the request. So no problem with that cash.
And Governor, has the central bank verified the bank's reports of open branches? I mean, we've got assurances from BDO and BPI, and yet we're also getting those customer complaints that they come to shut branches.
Well, we give the banks rather flexibility to open branches because, as you know, the demand for banking services at the moment is also limited because of the isolation. And so they may determine how many branches they want to open, and it's up to them to announce to their clients which branches are open. And at the same time, we encourage them to suspend all these charges imposed on the use of online banking, okay, including those imposed on the use of InstaPay and the PESONet. This will enable consumers to facilitate online banking transactions during this incident.
There is, as you say, this unprecedented need for cash, but knowing how to manage it is another. Gov, how should people manage their cash at this time? How much do we keep on hand, and how much transaction should be electronic?
They can do it electronically, that's better. But I cannot tell them how to manage their cash because many people have become irrational. They're out of fear. But there's a lot of cash. There's enough cash. Okay? There's also a risk if you hold a lot of cash, right? So I would suggest that to the extent that they can use or can transact business electronically, then that's better than holding cash.
And what about the loan payment extensions? It's a welcome reprieve for all, but can all banks handle loan payment extensions up to 90 days for some?
They can. I think we have prepared them well. We have asked them to create a lot of buffers. So we made a stress test, and they're all right. The banking industry is sound, and they're adequately capitalized. So under extreme situation, the banking industry will be fine. There will be above the 10% requirement of the BSP.
As to the overseas Filipino workers, Gov, they're also losing jobs. They've been disrupted by the travel bans. Those in Italy already losing them. What is your outlook for remittances then?
That will be another matter. That's beyond BSP, but I think the national government is addressing their concern. Last January, we had a higher than usual overseas Filipino OFW remittances, and I think this is basically because many of our OFWs have their own accounts. They have their own savings right there abroad, and they see that there's some problem domestically, and so they tend to send more electronically again. More remittances to their families here. So let's see. But that is being addressed by the national government. You know, one thing about the Philippine situation is that there's very close coordination between the president and Congress. In fact, Congress will convene tomorrow on a special session to approve the fiscal stimulus that the president will submit. And this is unlike, for example, in the U.S. where they can't seem to agree among themselves. Right? There's also, you have a government that's very serious. They meet every day, and they try to fix all the kinks in the strategy. And I think we'll come out of this stronger and better and more coordinated and more competitive.
Gov, how much supplemental budget is Malacanang eyeing? Salvador Panelo had mentioned $1.6 billion, but the businessmen are asking for more than that, over 280 billion pesos.
$1.6 billion, you said? How much?
Yes, that's what we got, but what are you hearing?
I think a good number will be about 100 to 200 billion. I think that will be enough to tide over the especially the Luzon population for the next 60 to 90 days.
And a final point, Gov, the dollar, it slid the most since 2016, ending the rally for now. What is your outlook for the dollar against the peso?
It's fairly steady, as you can see in the market, right? We have huge growth in the national reserves. And we have a steady inflow of foreign exchange. And with the oil prices going down, it has actually plummeted to close to $30 per barrel from $85 at its peak last in 2018. So we're benefiting from this. And because there's less demand for imports at this time, I think we'll be okay. We're looking at a very steady and stable peso.
All right. Thank you so much for the assurances there, Gov. I appreciate the time you've given. It's a Sunday. Keep well, Governor Ben Diokno of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas.
Thank you.